Now, if you watch my other videos on the Notes app, you saw how easy it is to create notes. You also saw how you can make them more useful by adding tables or checklists or bullets or even formatting a note. Well, in this video, we're going to see how we can keep them organized. We're going to look at how we can place them into folders, how we can add tags to notes, and even create smart folders for our notes. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we can make our notes or organize our notes on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. So I'm looking at my notes here, and the first thing I want to cover is how it is sorted. You may have seen this in the basics of notes, how this is all sorted. By default, this is sorted by when they were last edited. So if I go and edit this note here, what it's going to do is it's going to move it up towards the top. So let's go ahead and do that. I tap on it, and all I have to do is just make one change. I'm just going to add a space in here. So all I need to do is just make one change. And when I go back over to my notes, you're going to see that it moved it up towards the top. So it is sorting by when they were last edited. If you want to change that, what you can do is you can go to the Settings app. So I'm going to swipe up. Again, I covered this in the basic notes, but let's just take another look because it does help with organizing. So I go over here to my settings, and then we go down to the bottom here, tap on apps, and we need to go to notes. So I go over here to my notes, and one of the options that we have here is how we want to sort it. So I tap on sort by, and I can change it to date created or by the title. When it is sorted by date, we can also set if we want to group them by date, which is what I recommend leaving on. So then when you're looking at my notes, I actually like it sorted by when they were last edited. What we're going to see here is today and then the previous 30 days. So it's going to organize them by day. So that's how we can change the sort order. Now, another thing that we can do is we can move these into folders. We can create folders. So what I would like to do is maybe place these two into a folder. Maybe I'm going to Tulip Time. So what I would like to do is create a folder to have all of my notes on Tulip Time. How can I do that? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to go over here to folders. I tap on it. And these are all of my folders. You're going to have at least one folder called Notes. That's where all of your notes are. Now what I want to do is I want to create a new folder. So I just go over here to the new folder icon in the lower left-hand corner. And I call it Tulip Time. I'm going to call it Tulip Time Folder. I tap on Done. And now you're going to see that I have a new folder here. So now how do I move a note into that folder? If I open it up, you're going to see that there aren't any notes in there. How do I go and move something in there? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to go to all of our notes here. So I tap on notes or all iCloud, and then I long press on this. And when I long press on it, I get a contextual menu. And one of the options here is to move it. I tap on move. And now I can select where I want to move it to. In this case here, I'm going to move it to my Tulip Time folder. And now that is in my Tulip Time folder. Another way of doing that, I'm going to open up Tulip Time here. Another way of doing it is through the note itself. So I'm in the note itself. I want to move this over to that folder. I go to the ellipsis here, the three dots, and you're going to see I have the option to move that note. So let's go ahead and do that. Move note, I select Tulip Time, and now it is in that folder. So you're going to see that it is no longer here. Why is that? Well, that's because I'm looking at my notes. And remember, I moved those over to my Tulip Time folder. So when I go into that folder, now I can see those two notes. Now, if you want to nest a folder, you can do that as well. I can create another folder in here. If we look in the lower left-hand corner, there's no way that I can create a folder. So how do I nest it? Well, essentially what we need to do is we need to create the folder, and then we move that folder into another folder. So let's go ahead and do that. New folder, and I'm going to call this nested. Tap on done, and you can see we have nested here. I want to move that into that other folder. I long press on it. And then I can move it, and then I can move it into my Tulip Time folder. So I tap on it, and now when we go to my Tulip Time folder, we can see we have my nested folder there. So we can even nest folders, but what we have to do is we have to go and create the folder first, and then from there what we're able to do is move it. If I want to move it out, I can do that as well. I just long press on it, and I tap on move, and I just put it into iCloud here, and now it is no longer nested, it is outside of that, and it's just in all of my folders here. So that's how we create folders and even nest folders. Now I'm going to show you a little tip here with nested folders. I can also use drag and drop. So instead of long pressing on it and then selecting move, I can also just drag this on top of another folder. So I drag it, place it on top of another folder, and you're going to see that it gets a little dark there. And when I do that, it actually nested it. Another thing we can do is we can create smart folders. Smart folders are where it will place a note in the folder automatically. We don't actually have to physically move a note into a folder. It'll do it automatically based on certain criteria. So how do we create a smart folder? Well, again, we go down to our new folder here, and we go and name it. So I'm just going to call this smart folder. And then you're going to see make into a smart folder. When I tap on that, what I can do is I can set specific criteria. So let's say I wanted to have all of the notes that were edited in the last 7 days. So now what it's going to do is it's going to show me all of the notes that were edited in the last 7 days. Maybe what I want to do is also show all of the notes that have an attachment. So I just go with attachment, and this is going to be any, although I could select a photo or a link or anything like that. And now what it's going to do, it's going to match all of these filters. So it's going to show me all of the notes that have been edited in the last 7 days that also have an attachment. So let's go and see how this works. Tap on done, done, and we have my smart folder here. And if we look, we have two notes in there. Both of those notes have been edited in the last 7 days, and they both have attachments. If you want to edit a smart folder, you just long press on it. So I'm going to long press on smart folder here. And when I do, what I'm able to do is edit the smart folder, and I can go and change the criteria. I can go and change the filters. So we have a lot of different options in here for our different filters. So that's how we can create smart folders. With smart folders, again, we don't place the note in there. The Notes app will do it automatically based on specific criteria or specific filters. Now, another way of organizing our notes is with tags. Tags give us a little bit more flexibility than folders. What we're able to do is we're able to add multiple tags to a note, and then we can view all of those notes that have that tag. Let's see what I mean. Let's go back over to my Tulip Time here. I tap on it. And we're going to go to Tulip Time. I want to add a tag to this. I want to tag it as Tulip Time. Well, in order to do that, all we have to do is just tap in here. And then we just go with the pound sign. And I type in here the tag name. In this case, it's going to be Tulip Time. It does have to be one word. So we can see we have it up here. Now what I do is I hit return. And when I hit return, what it's going to do is it's going to tell the Notes app that is a tag. And we can see that it actually changed color. So that is a tag. That's how we're going to add it. Let's go and add it to another one. We're going to go to all of our notes here. And let's just say that this relates to Tulip Time as well. I tap on it, and I want to go and add a tag to it. So I just go up to the top. I go with the pound sign. And first thing you're going to see is it's pulling up that tag. I don't have to retype it because it's a tag. I could retype it, but all I have to do really is just tap on that, and it adds that tag in there. Let's go and do that one more time. We're going to go to another note, and let's go with things to do. I tap on it, and I can put the tag anywhere. I'm going to put it down towards the bottom here. Again, I go with the pound sign. And again, I tap on Tulip Time. and we can see it added that tag. Okay, so now how does this work? I have Tulip Time and three different notes, and one of them is in the Tulip Time folder. Well, when we go back to all of our folders, you're going to see that I have a new option here, Tags. And all I need to do to look at all of those notes that I tagged is just tap on Tulip Time. And there are those three notes. It doesn't matter where they are, it doesn't matter what folder they're in. What it's going to do is it's going to show me all of the notes that have that tag. As I mentioned, what we're able to do is add multiple tags. Let's go and add another one. So we're going to go to the Tulip Time folder and camera, and let's go and add another tag in here. So this time, what we're going to do is we're going to call this one camera. I hit return, and we can see that it added it in there. And we're going to add Tulip Time to this one. So I just tap on Tulip Time, and now we have Tulip Time. So now I tap on Done. We have those two tags in there. And now you're going to see I have Camera and Tulip Time. So what I want to do is view all my camera notes. There they are. Now the last thing I want to talk about is accounts. In most cases, we're only going to have one account. Basically, all my notes on my iPhone here are stored in my iCloud account. So I only have one account on here. But in some cases, you may see more than one account. Why is that? Well, that's because other services also support notes. If you have a Gmail address, that will support an account in Notes. I have a Gmail account connected to this iPhone. So let's go ahead and see how we can create another account and why we may want to do that as well as why we may not want to do that. So what I'm going to do is go to my Settings app. I swipe up and then we go over here to Settings. We need to go to our Notes settings to manage the account. I tap on it. And again, we go over here to Apps and then we need to go to Notes. Once I find Notes here, I tap on it, and then you're going to see Accounts, and I have three of them. But if we look at Notes, I only have one account there. When I go to my Notes, you're going to see that I have one account. Why does it say three? Well, that's because I do have three accounts that are compatible with the Notes, but I don't have them showing. So when I go back over to my Settings, and we go to Notes Accounts here, you're going to see that I have my three accounts here, iCloud, Gmail, and Dan at Dan's Tutorials. But one of them is inactive. Dan at Dan's Tutorials is inactive, so it's not connected to anything. And Gmail is only connected to my mail. Well, if I wanted to also have it connect to my notes, all I do is just tap on it. And then I just turn on Notes. And when I do, it's going to add another account to my Notes app. So watch what happens now when I go to my Notes app. Gmail. So now I have two accounts. So if you're seeing two or more accounts, that is because you have an account in the Notes app that is compatible with Notes. Now, why would you want to do this? Well, in some cases, you may want to separate your notes by account. So maybe you have a work account and you have your personal account. So you want to have all of your work notes in here and all of your personal notes in here. So that's why you may want to have another account. But also what it does is it adds a layer of complexity. It can be confusing. Where did you save that note? Did you save it in Gmail or did you save it in iCloud? So it adds another layer of complexity. So if you don't really need to have multiple accounts, what I would recommend doing is turning off any of the services that you no longer want to use. I just use my iCloud for notes. So what I would do is I would turn off my notes in Gmail. But before you do that, you can move a note from one account to another. So if I go into my notes here, and let's say I wanted this to be in my Gmail, I just go and move it to my Gmail. So what you are able to do is move all of your accounts into another account. And then once you do that, when it is empty, then what you can do is you can go and delete that. So I hope that makes sense. Go and move all of your notes from that account into another account so they're all in one account. And then, once you do that, just turn off notes for that account. And when you do that, it's going to delete those notes from your iPhone, but you already moved them, so it doesn't really matter. There's nothing there to delete. And then, It's going to keep it nice and simple. You have one account. So that's why you may want to have more than one account on your iPhone. Maybe want to separate it by personal and work as an example. But again, also why you may not want to. It just adds another layer of complexity. Where did I store that note? So that is how we can organize our notes on the iPhone. We can do something as simple as just create a folder and move notes into those folders. We can also create smart folders where it'll do it for us automatically based on different criteria. We also have tags where we can add a tag to a note and then keep them organized through tags. And we can even combine that with our smart folders. And then we can also create multiple accounts for our notes. So that is how we can organize our notes on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. Not only do I have more videos there, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. How are you supporting a small business? Well, it is a membership-based site. When you become a member, what I'll do for you is I'll take out all of the ads from the videos. You'll have access to that AI assistant, and you have access to my classes and webinars. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.